Now at 5:30, we've learned that a second victim involved in a Madison County wreck on Tuesday has died at UK Hospital.
Also on WKYT this morning, after two out-of-state truck drivers allegedly caused crashes here in Kentucky, we pulled crash numbers over the last 5 years in the Commonwealth, and we'll tell you what we've discovered.
And a Lexington woman who says she's been the target of vandals tells us she's been targeted once more.
Tracking, alerting, protecting. This is WKYT This Morning.
Good morning to you on your Friday, and welcome to WKYT This Morning. I'm Bill Bryant.
And I'm Rebecca Smith. We're hoping that the rains, you know, somewhat subside in order to let folks engage in their activities this weekend. A lot of stuff planned, well, including marathons.
That's the deal. I mean, you plan so many things.
Yeah.
Graduation at EKU this evening and some other things. And then, yeah, the sprinkles start moving in this morning. And what's next? We're going to check in with meteorologist Micah Harris, who's tracking things in our First Alert Weather Center. Good morning.
Hey, good morning, guys. We still have a few showers out there this morning. Afternoon, it's a few thunderstorms, and that is going to be the start of a pretty wet trend throughout the next few days. Now, let's go through it. We have a little batch of rain. Remember, this is not heavy. There's some light activity, a couple of showers here and there, but it's sliding eastbound, heads up 127 and 27. You're going to be seeing this glide right over your neck of the woods in the next 30 minutes to about an hour. Lexington at 65, 67 London Corbin area. It goes for Williamsburg down in Whitley County. It is a mild start this morning. It'll be a warm afternoon at 81 degrees. A couple of thunderstorms here and there, but it really ramps up there for your weekend. Unfortunately, I know we have a lot going on, and I'll show you your latest forecast. When you can expect all that? Coming up in a few minutes.
Okay, thank you. We'll see you in a bit. Let's get to the news.
Well, a crash that took the life of an EKU nursing student has now claimed the life of another student at the school.
We've learned that 23-year-old Cody Garcia, who is from Lexington, died late last night. WKYT's Mark Barber is live at UK Hospital. Mark, what has the Fayette County coroner told us about this?
Good morning, Bill. Well, I can tell you that the coroner says EKU student Cody Garcia died here at UK Hospital around 9:45 last night from a traumatic brain injury. Many classmates of the EKU student, just 23 years old, hoped that he would somehow recover after he was critically hurt in a car crash on Tuesday. The crash on Jacks Creek Road in Madison County also injured two other EKU students and killed 20-year-old Alyssa Moorman. She was a sophomore in the EKU nursing program. Investigators are still trying to figure out what caused the two-car crash. Garcia's classmates plan to remember the 23-year-old Lexington man at a candlelight vigil at Tates Creek High School at 8 p.m. on Tuesday. We spoke with his friends last night while they were holding a vigil for Moorman.
Always down for anything. He always cared. He was he always has your back. He's an all-over great guy.
Such a tragedy. Now, Garcia's friend set up a GoFundMe page online yesterday to help raise money for his family's finances. In just one day, they have already raised $4,300 from 128 donors. Live in Lexington, Mark Barber, WKYT.
Well, two out-of-state semi-truck drivers have been arrested after crashing in Kentucky in the past week. Police charged Miroslav Kuzmanik with reckless homicide and wanton endangerment. Police say he caused a deadly crash on Interstate 64 in Shelby County. Last Friday in Laurel County, police arrested James Buell because they say he crashed a UPS truck while driving drunk. We pulled crash numbers for the last 5 years available. From 2009 to 2013, the number of out-of-state drivers going through Kentucky climbed 21%.
There's more trucks on the road than there were in the past. It's cheaper for companies to move freight by truck than it would be by air or even by train. So you're starting to see a little bit more of an increase in trucks than what you would normally see.
Well, Officer Tinsley says with out-of-state truck drivers, federal rather than state laws usually apply. He says state officers have to honor rules for the state the drivers are licensed in. On WKYT.com, we have an interactive chart where you can get a more in-depth look at the semi-truck crash data in Kentucky. Kind of interesting to find out that federal rules apply.
Well, it is interesting and something that we need to watch, obviously, with these accidents that have been happening.
Stay safe on the roads. Well, details keep emerging in what exactly led up to a tragic train crash that killed 8 people in Philadelphia.
We now know that the train accelerated up to the point where it crashed. In addition, the train's engineer, Brandon Bostian, has agreed to an interview with the National Transportation Safety Board. His lawyer says Bostian had a concussion from the crash and can't remember much about it. An NTSB board member also says the Amtrak train left the Philadelphia station on time to get to New York, but it headed into a curve going twice the speed limit when it crashed. Got some sad news to report this morning out of Nevada. Blues legend B.B. King has died at the age of 89. His daughter says he died in Las Vegas after 2 weeks in hospice care. He suffered from type 2 diabetes for the last several years before his passing. The Mississippi native reigned as the king of blues for more than 6 decades and influenced countless other musicians.
Losing a legend there. Well, a Spencer County man is behind bars facing charges of incest rape this morning. Authorities tell us it's because he got a 13-year-old girl pregnant. The father of the girl says he and his ex-wife shared custody of their daughter. He says the man accused, 33-year-old Jamal Hunt, was living with the teen's mother at the time. The father of the girl says the abuse could have stopped before his daughter became pregnant. Hunt will appear before a judge next Thursday.
The time this morning is 5:36 on WKYT. A Lexington woman tells us just days after vandals shot paintballs at her home, the vandals have struck once again. This time, Janet Freeman says they threw a bag filled with rocks right through her bedroom window. Freeman lives on Pemberton Street in the East End neighborhood. She says last week someone fired 28 paintballs at her house. The window was broken yesterday morning, and Freeman says she's about had enough.
I don't get angry, I get sad. It saddens me. It ruins a neighborhood because it separates people.
Freeman has installed a security system, and she says the people responsible for breaking her window today have been caught on tape. Lexington police are reviewing the video. Freeman says she thinks she is being targeted because she is a member of the Citizens Police Academy. Investigators tell us that a man has died in eastern Kentucky while trying to steal copper from an idle mine. The Martin County Sheriff says the man climbed a substation in the Pilgrim community while trying to reach copper and metal brackets. But the sheriff says the man touched a live power line and was electrocuted. The sheriff says a person with the man ran to try to get help. That person is now facing criminal trespassing charges. We called the Martin County Sheriff's Office early this morning. They couldn't tell us the name of the person who's killed.
Police need your help finding a man they say has stolen more than $3,800 worth of merchandise from a Laurel County Walmart. The Laurel County Sheriff's Office released some surveillance photos of the suspect. They say he stole goods from a Walmart near Corbin on May 1st and again on May 6th. Excuse me. Police say both times the man left the store with a loaded cart. They say he stole batteries, tools, and clothes. Investigators think the man could be in a dark-colored Chrysler 300 car.
Two boys in Harlan County are facing charges after police say they broke into a barber shop there. Tim Howard says the burglars stole more than $50 along with tickets to an upcoming sporting event and bubble gum. Now, police say the boys ended up admitting to the break-in after they were caught. Howard says one of them is a former customer.
They would be in a hard spot. I would credit haircuts. And they would come in and pay me around the first of the month. And, you know, you try to be good to people, and that's how you get repaid.
Howard says after the burglary, he bought surveillance cameras to put up around his shop. Police charged each boy with third-degree burglary and criminal mischief.
New this morning, the Harrodsburg Police Department is warning folks to watch out for money scams. Officers posted this photo of a fake document from Bill Trust Financial Incorporated. The letter tells the person who gets it that they won $250,000. All you have to do is cash the enclosed check worth $3,300 as a processing fee. Police say you will not be getting any money back. Police say if you get something like this, you should call them at the number you see there on your screen.
And don't fall for that.
Yeah,
right?
A lot of times it looks pretty real, so just keep that
absolutely.
In mind that it is a scam. Well, there is a busy weekend ahead in Lexington. The Alltech Brewfest, other events like Taste the Bluegrass tonight. We've got the marathon, all expected to clog city streets.
And it's all ahead of a packed weekend schedule, and one lane of a major downtown thoroughfare is going to be closed. Let's go to WKYT's Victor Puente live downtown with a look at this weekend's activities. Victor, which road should people in particular be watching out for?
Yeah, thousands of people will be driving through downtown Lexington this weekend and running. Now, if you take Main Street, you will have one less lane to travel on. The right lane of West Main Street will be closed beginning today. That closure between Limestone and Upper. It's for construction of the 21C Hotel. Two lanes and a left turn lane will still be open. Downtown is expected to be packed this weekend with a crowd coming for the Alltech Craft Brews and Food Fest. That's happening Saturday. But the morning will begin with the Horse Capital Marathon. Runners will go through horse country starting at Fassig Tipton on Newtown Pike. It's the first full sanctioned marathon in Lexington since 1980. Then the festival will take place at Heritage Hall. That starts at noon with 51 different breweries. Now, city engineers plan on adjusting the red lights at West Main and Upper to give drivers more time. They plan to have that lane reopened by July 4th. Live in Lexington, Victor Puente, WKYT.
All right, let's get a traffic, see what's happening this morning.
And let's look outside right now and take a live camera for you downtown. This is at Broadway and High Street, and right now things are quiet there. No reports of any trouble. Obviously, just now Victor was detailing the issues going on in Lexington, and we have the traffic advisory over in Richmond as well, because tonight they'll be having outdoor graduation at Roy Kidd Stadium and nearby at the EKU Center for the Arts. Kathy Griffin,
who just quit Fashion Police a little while back. They had that whole dust up. They're not coming back until September. That's the plan for that show, if you watch E! Or Fashion Police. But anyway, Kathy Griffin from that show will be at EKU.
Yes, so big crowd expected, and they expect a lot of traffic on the roads in the 6 and 7 o'clock hour there in Richmond this evening. So everybody kind of keep that one in mind. Good to have you along. I'm WKYT for your Friday as we roll toward the weekend.
Yay! Well, they sure do hurt when you step on one, but you'll really want to avoid stepping on these logos. We'll tell you about this special exhibit in France in about 5 minutes.
Few showers this morning. We head toward the afternoon, and here comes some thunderstorms in the forecast, and that'll take you through your weekend too. It just does not look good. I'll show you your latest forecast coming up.